She came to the United States at the age of 12, went on to open a small family-run restaurant in Queens, then came to New York City, to Manhattan, and took the food world by storm. And just recently, Crain's New York Business named Lydia Bastianich one of the 100 most influential businesswomen in New York City. Lydia Bastianich, a woman with great vision, desire, and fantastic success. Lydia, you have restaurants, you've got cookbooks, you travel to Italy, you've got the vineyard, you know, you're a chef, you're always out on the move in this world. How do you do this all? How does it work?
Well, Valerie, with a lot of help, but I think what's essential for all of this to happen is that I love what I do, there's a passion there, and I have a grand time. But I also have a great team now. It's my family's involved, my daughter, my son, but a lot of competent people.
Yeah, it's a team. It's Team Lydia is what I like to call it.
Yeah, if you like to call it that, I think it sounds good. Sounds
team
good.
Lydia. And you were honored by so many people recently with the last year, the Grand Marshal of the Columbus Day Parade. And Crain's named you an influential businesswoman in New York, which is quite an honor.
Yeah, there was part of, you know, 100 women chosen, and I felt tremendously honored and accomplished, I must say. You know, sometimes when other people tell you something, it says, yeah, do I do that? But I think, you know, what I do is maybe more of an art form, not thought of, you know, okay, she's strictly business. But in order for these things to happen, you have to have a business plan, in a sense, or a business structure. And again, that is a sensibility. I know that I love to do many things, but unless it makes business sense, then I don't have a venue. And to that end, you know, I have my personal sensibility, but again, it's surrounding yourself with the right people, with competent financial people that lead you in the right direction. And I must say that one of those people is my son, Joseph, who, as you know, after school, growing up in the restaurant, going to school, went down to Wall Street, got 3 years of Wall Street under his belt, and then came back to the family business, and that really adds a lot of sort of economic or financial energy.